windows high. Thank you.
Okay, a little announcement about people on the deck here. Somebody's already like put their foot through the deck, so you guys gotta take it easy on it, because somebody's gonna hurt themselves, we're gonna hurt the deck, and it's gonna be a lot of hurting going on. It's really gonna hit. rock and your head say.
Oh, hauling timber. Oh, timber. Oh, this timber's got a roll. Hauling timber. Oh, timber. Oh, this timber's got a roll. Now, Jerry was an Arkansas mule. Been everywhere and he ain't no fool. When I'm 122, done everything a poor mule can do.
Hauling
timber. Oh, timber. Oh, this timber's got a roll.
Hauling timber.
Thank you. tossing Jerry in a cave and jump. Jerry really kicked the boss off the rump. My old Jerry was a cool mule. Had a big load how to kill that fool. Boss tried to shoot old Jerry in the head. Jerry took that bullet and it stopped again. Stopped that boss till he heard him scream. Shut up, Jerry was so damn mean on him.
Thank you.
Awesome.
just had a casserole. Oh, oh,
oh, oh. Roses and zombies that roses. Whoa, pasta.
Yeah.
saw the Armenian man who groveled toward her and stood by her side with a bucket that swung in his hand. His grin stretched the folds of his pasty white cheeks, and his lips hurled a dollop of murk on the curb. And the lights from the ride showed a mischievous sparkle that flashed in his hollow-eyed stare. He said, "Little girl, you can chop off my legs and then peel off my socks if you want to. But I'd rather you took this old puppet from me that I hold in my pail as we speak." And he stood looking down at the innocent girl, and she stared at the bucket, bewildered, till he lifted the doll for the young girl to see, and a giant smile grew on his face. She saw the doll's eyes, and she couldn't resist, and she thanked the man quickly and ran to the church, and she burst through the doorway with puppet held high, and a hush filled the chapel, and the people looked beaming.
Part of town.
privilege. Sure to find the evil man in the rotten village. In the darkest hour of night. Nervously she fumbled for the pouch that held the puppet on her rump. Feeling quite outnumbered, Esther hid behind a nearby pile of lumber. Where she waited till the dawn. Cause it would have been a blunder to succumb to a hoodlum on the prowl. When the morning came, she wandered through the streets along the chilly lake that lay beside the town. At last, a peaceful moment. She thought she heard a sound. It was an angry mob of joggers coming up to knock her down. As Esther shook her head, the joggers were approaching, and she knew she had no choice left but to swim. As the frosty water sank its bitter teeth into her eye, she tried to slide the heavy clothing from her skin. Naked now, she made her way toward the shore, when suddenly she a tiny tugging at her toe. And the puppet she had forgotten wrapped its tiny little arms around her ankle, and it wouldn't let her go. The waves seemed to open and swallow her whole as the doll holds her down through the eerie green deep. And the sound of the laughing old man filled her ears as she
My sweet one, I call you my sweet one. You're my only true sweet one. With my arms, I call you my sweet one. From far away, I'll say your name. But with you, I'll travel big. And with you, I'll also travel big. And all the spaces in between, I'll travel with you. You're my sweet one.
Down, 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 down Thank you. too.
His name was Rutherford the Brain, and he was on a quest to save his people from the fate that lay before them. His clumsy end was perilously near. The lizards would be saved, he said, if they could be enlightened by the writings of the helping friendly monk. In all of Prussia, only one existed, and Wilson had declared that any person who possessed it was a crook. He said, I come from the land of darkness. He said, I come from the land of doom. He said, I come from the land of evil. From the land of the man baboon. But I never am going back there. And I couldn't if I tried. Cause I come from the land of lizards. And the lizards, they have died. And the lizards, they have died. And the lizards, they have died. And the lizards, they have died.
Thank you. because microphones sound so good to announce over. There's a guy named Era, and he sells shirts that he's hand-painted himself. If you see him around here, there was a shirt that he lost at Buck Steep Manor in Washington, Mass. At a Max Creek show. And it was found on the ground. And if you want to return it to him, bring it to the stage.
That's Heather Paul, sister of the infamous Dave Paul. So this is a special birthday dedication.
Thank you. Thank you. banana tree on the rugged trail toward the balcony. A child of the 20th century, a dried up lion and a weasel named Fee. Far away in another place, a fading beauty named Millie Grace. A gospel story, fox on a face, and a man who came to help her keep the peace. Fee was a Buddhist prodigy, long past the age of maturity. Someday he knew it would set him free, like it did for Floyd, the chimpanzee. So have a cup of coffee and catch your breath. Whoa, oh me. You're trying to live a life that's completely free. You're racing with the wind, you're flirting with death. So have a cup of coffee and catch your breath. Desperate craving in his bones, their love he said, I will not condone. Then one day on a ship to Quebec, Floyd found me and Millie on a lover's trek. He picked up a bottle and broke off the neck. It sliced through the air and feed him the dead.
Trying to live a life that's completely free. You're racing with the wind. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Once two strangers climbed a rocky top looking for moonshine still. Strangers ain't gone down a rocky top, reckon they never will. Cold old crowd all on rocky top, there's too rocky by far. That's why all the folks on rocky top get their corn from a jar. Rocky top, you'll always be home sweet home. Thank you.
and gentlemen, would you please welcome the one and only
saying that line. It's like the last line of the song. I gotta apologize. This is what the song I could while away the hours, confirm and move the flowers, consult him with the rain. My head I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain. I could solve any riddle for any old rule, trouble or in pain. With the thoughts I'd be thinking, I could be another Lincoln if I only had the brain. I could think of things I never thought before, and then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nut, my head all full of stuff and heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry, life would be a ding-a-dairy if I only had a brain. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you guys. Thanks.
Thank you. takes you back to your old world.
Everybody now, all of a sudden.
The tires are the things on your car that make contact with the road.
Yes, it is.
Yes, we am.
Yes, we am.
The tires are the things on your car that make contact with the road.
Here we are.
The tires are the things on your car that make contact with the road.
One more time for Carly Skremski.
The car is the thing on the road that takes you back to your home.
Excuse me. I have an announcement, a very important announcement. stage, I try to do all those things the best I can.
Yeah, when my woman left home with a better man, but it's a long time to care.